So should we start? They will join in between and I will share the link. So should we start?
Hello.
Should we start?
Sir, wait for 5 minutes. Sir, join कर रहे हैं.
Okay. So I think we should start, and if somebody will join, they will join in between. I will recall all those things which we have discussed in the morning, so people will join in between, and if somebody has missed it, they can see the link. I will share the link for them. So the morning thing, I'm just recalling it because we were, some voice issue was there. So we were discussing the line charge in the morning, and we have came into a conclusion that basically line charge is, so suppose some object we are placing like wire, and that wire, if you are inducing an amount of charge there, so basically line charge will be equal to, so line charge will be defined as total charge upon length of the wire. So that we have already discussed in the morning. And so suppose this wire is there, so for this wire I'm calculating the line charge. So if they are asking you to find the line charge at some coordinate, at some point, so suppose if I am considering this point as dl and I am pouring a dq amount of charge here, so what I will get from that? So from that, rho l will be equal to dq by dl. So we are getting that dq will be equal, integration of dq is q, that is charge, and that will be equal to integration of rho l into dl. So that we had already find here. So two formula we need to remember, first one and second one in line charge. So for the same, we have discussed about volume charge, surface charge. So for surface charge, I told you, suppose this surface is there, and if they are asking you to find the surface charge of this whole surface, so what we will do, we'll write here like total charge upon area of surface. So for that whole surface, we have derived this formula, and if they will ask you to find the charge on this point or this coordinate or this coordinate, so I'm taking as ds, so, and I'm powering here dq amount of charge here, so what I will get here from this, so rho s is equal to dq by ds, and that is equal to dq will be equal to rho s into ds. So we will write like this, that integration of dq equal to q equal to rho s ds. So for this is our surface charge which we have discussed, and surface charge is very important for the capacitor because it is like a square. So these two parallel lines will be there in a capacitor, so it is very essential for capacitors. So now I will move to, now we have discussed the volume charge. So I will show you, I am giving the overview of the morning scenario which we have discussed. So I'm just discussing all those things the morning which we have seen. So for volume charge also we have seen in the morning, so I'll write here for volume charge. So for volume charge, so suppose this surface is any random variable will be there, so if you are for calculating the volume for this random variable, so rho v will be equal to total charge, that is q, which we have powered in this surface, so total charge upon the total volume of the object. So that is the basic thing. And if sometimes they're asking as a function of coordinate, or they will ask to calculate at some point, if they will ask you to calculate at this point, hello, now we class le rahe, abhi phone karte hain aapko. ठीक है। So suppose this is the surface. So for that, I'll write here rho v equal to dq by dv. So the dq will calculate is dv, and we will do the integration of dq. What we'll get q equal to rho v into dv. So this is same. It is exactly same for volume also. So this we have discussed here. Now we will solve some problem based on these charges, so that you will get some clear idea. We were already discussing one problem, but due to sound problem, it was not clear to you. So I will one more time. I will write this problem. Please try to write it. If you write it, you'll get an idea. So question was like this. Said if the please write the question. If the line charge density that is rho L is equal to 24 J square millicoulomb by M, and they are asking you to find the total charge on y axis from minus 5 to plus 5. So the question was like this, that if the line charge is given as 24 y square millicoulomb by meter and millimeter, and they were asking you to calculate, find the total charge on y axis from the coordinates were from minus 5 to plus 5. So first of all, we'll draw the figure. So this is the line charge, and the coordinates which we are given for this line charge is from here to here, that is minus 5 to plus 5, and this is, we are all calculating in the y axis. So what we will do here, so already we were aware of the fact that q is given as rho l into dl. So we are aware of this formula which we have done. This is rho. So what I will just substitute the value here. So I will write here 24 into y square dy, and since it is mc upon millicube by meter, so I'll write here into 10 to the power minus 3, and the limit will be minus 5 to plus 5. So limit will be minus 5 to plus 5. This will be our limit. So you are already, so this is the constant term. I'll take it out. So I'll write here 24 into 10 to the power minus 3. You are good with integration, I hope. So you will integrate this, you will put the limit here after. So this 3 will divide it by 8. What I will get here, 8 into 10 to the power minus 3, and 5 cube will be 125, plus minus will become 125. What I will write here, 2000 into 10 to the power minus 3, and when you will write here 2 coulomb. So this will be the first question which we have solved, which we have already seen. So if you are having any kind of doubt in this first question, please tell me, or we'll move to second question. So we'll solve one problem based on surface, then we will solve one problem based on volume, then so it all will be clear. So suppose this problem has came into our paper which I'm going to solve. So please write the question, and after that we'll solve this. So we had already solved this kind of problem here. So now this topic will become simple, because earlier I had not given an overview of this topic, but I had applied in the formula these things. So you may be confused how we are direct. So my motive was that if you will understand this, if you have got at that time, so now it will be very simple for you. So I have directly written their line charge, volume charge, this line charge is changing into surface. So all these things I was directly doing there. So I wanted to make a point so that after this you will not be having any difficulties. So we move to. So second question they had asked in your paper. So it was in your paper. So question was like that. So it was of 8 mark. The problem was of 8 mark. So based on the surface charge density. So the problem was like that. That a square plate resulting in, please write the question, resulting in a xy plane is situated in the space defined by the coordinates which were given minus 3 to x 3, and the coordinates for y axis will be minus 3 to y to 3. So they were asking you to find the total charge on the plane if surface charge density is given by rho s equal to 4y square microcoulomb per meter square. So this was the question, and that carried so please write the question. I think this question is visible to you. Please write it. I will define one more time. We'll solve it somewhere. So question was given that a square plate resulting in xy plane is situated in the space defined by the coordinate of x-axis was -3 to 3 and the coordinate of y-axis was -3 to 3. And they were asking you to find the total charge on the plate if surface density is given by rho s. So see, in the question also, they are asking you to find the total charge density of the plate. So I don't know what is happening today. So see, everybody has written the question, so we'll solve it. I don't know what is happening today. So first we'll draw the figure here. So that was given, the square plate was given here, and two coordinates were given, x-axis and y-axis. So this is our x-axis and this is our y-axis. So first of all, we need to draw the figure. So x-axis was varying from -3 to +3, and y-axis was also varying from -3 to +3, and the rho s was given as 4y square microcoulomb per meter square. So this was, so never get afraid of the question. Always try to read it one or two times. If you'll read it one or two times, you'll get an idea. So always, whatever you know, just write on the paper, whatever you know. So we are aware of the fact that this is a surface charge. So for surface charge, we had made a diagram for x coordinates and for y coordinates. X coordinates were varying from -3 to +3, and y coordinates were varying from -3 to +3. And because this square plane was given in an xy plane, so now you need to just substitute the formula. So this was 8-mark question. So when I will solve it, you will see how this question is very simple. So it was asked 2 or 3 years back, if you'll see your question paper. So see, just I will apply the formula here. So we are aware that how to find the surface charge integration. So if they are asking, the question was, they were asking that find the total charge on the plate if the surface charge density is. So they are asking for the full plate. If you read the question, they are asking for the full plate. So never get confused of that. The DQ term, the DL term, which I have told you, that was for a certain coordinates. If they will ask for a certain coordinates, then we will apply DQ and DL there. So since they were asking for full surface, so we are already aware that what we will do here, we'll just write the formula rho s into ds. Why I have written this? Because they are asking for the full coordinates. So I think everybody is clear with that. So if it will not like that, then we had applied for that DQ formula if they have asked for some certain coordinates. So for this, if they are asking for full, so I had applied this formula. So now, so this is the surface integration of surface charge density. So now I will substitute the value here. So two double integration will be there. So it's two surfaces there, x and y. And I will write here 4y square dx dy, since it is of two surface. So x is varying from -3 to +3. Y is varying from -3 to +3. Dx, because two surfaces are there. Dx is dx for one and dy for y surface. So now integration, now we will finally do the integration. So see, since it is a same coordinate, we will integrate it simultaneously. All the things are in multiplication and independent variables are there. No dependent variables are there. No variable is dependent on a certain value. So since it is an independent variable and it is in multiplication, so we will do it at a time. So what I will write, so this dx integration will become x. What I will write here, I will take the constant term 4 outside. So I will write here 4x, because of this dx, it will become x minus 3, 2, 3. Then for y, it will become y cube by 3 minus 3, 2, 3 into microcoulomb is there. So I will write here 10 to the power minus 6, since it is a microcoulomb. So you just need to solve this problem. So see, problem will become very easy here. What I will write here, 4 into 10 to the power minus 6 into 6 into 1 by 3. If you'll integrate, you'll get this value. And if you'll substitute the value, 9 plus 9. So after solving into your calculator, we'll get the value 4.32 mini coulomb. If you'll open this, you have to multiply with 10 to the power minus 3. So this is the simple answer, and that will have, that carries of 8 mark. A part, B part was also there, and in that B part, they had asked some definition. So some small definition was there, and that full problem was of 8 mark. So see how simple problem is that. You just need to see if it is a surface charge, if it is a volume charge, if it is a line charge, if they're asking for total surface or they're asking for a particular surface. So you just need to see that. And after that, what are the basic thing you are aware of? What are the basic formula which you have known? So you have to just apply this. So if you have any kind of doubt in this question, please tell me, or we'll move to other questions. So please tell. Okay. So we'll move to an spherical cell. So one more question was there, which had been asked in gate for a subjective two numbers. So see the question, a thick spherical cell centered at origin extend between r equal to 2 centimeter and r equal to 3 centimeter. If the volume charge density is rho v is given as 3 r into 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter mercury, find the So you wanted to try, or should I solve it? Should I solve it, or you wanted to try? What should we do? Please tell. Okay, no answer. So I assume that you wanted to solve. You wanted me to solve it. So. See, question was like that, a thick spherical cell centered at the origin and the dimension were given as, radius was given as, it is varying from 2 centimeter to 3 centimeter. And if the volume charge density rho v is given as 3 r into 10 to the power minus 4 centimeter per meter cube, find the total charge contained in the cell. So first of all, what we need to do, we needed to draw the figure. We'll draw the figure. So since it is a volume charge, we'll draw the figure of a volume charge. And a thick spherical cell centered at the origin extend between r equal to 2 centimeter and r equal to 3 centimeter. So I'll write here. So one is of 2 centimeter. So this is the volume charge density in that 2 centimeter things is there, and it is varying. So I'll draw the coordinates here. This is x coordinates. Since it is volume, 3 coordinates is there. This is y coordinates, and this is z coordinate. And this thing is of 2 centimeter and this thing of 3 centimeter. This is of 3 centimeter. And they're asking is the charge density for the whole volume cell, if you have seen the question here. So see, so for spherical coordinates, for the time being, just remember these things. In the next sessions, I will tell you the coordinates of the coordinates of sphere. All those coordinates I will discuss you in the next session. For these sessions, please remember this, that for spherical coordinates, the r will vary from 2 into the 10 to the power minus 2 to 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. Three things are there in the spherical coordinates, r, theta, and phi. So for this time being, just remember this. I'll discuss this all these things in the next sessions. How this the coordinates? How will got theta? How I am getting phi? So three coordinates are there. So three coordinates will be, first coordinate will be r, second coordinate will be theta, third will be phi. Theta is varying from 0 to pi. Phi is varying from 0 to 2 pi. So for the time being, just remember this two things, that these are varying from 0 to pi and other is varying from 0 to 2 pi. Phi is varying from, all these things I will discuss in the next session. When we will be discussing the coordinates of all this system, then we will discuss how this is 0 to pi and how this is 0 to 2 pi. So for now, just remember this, in a volume charge density, three things are there. So in a Cartesian coordinate, two things are there in Cartesian and spherical coordinate system. So in Cartesian coordinate system, we'll see with x, y and z. But in this spherical cell, since we are discussing, so this x will become r, y will become theta and z will become phi. So only these things are, difference is there. These things will be converted into this. So since we are discussing of a spherical cell, so this x, y, z will change into r, theta and phi. So you just need to remember these things. So now if they are asking the total charge density contained in the cell, so for the whole cell, they are asking the total charge density. So we are already aware of that formula for this is rho into V dV. So if you are aware with this formula, we just needed to apply this formula. If you apply this, what you will write here, rho V into R square sine theta dr d theta d phi. You just need to remember this. For a spherical coordinate system, we needed to write this thing. You just remember this. I will discuss how these things are coming here. I will discuss all those things. So now you need to apply the limits here. So what I will do here. So for phi, it is varying from 0 to 2 pi. For theta, it is varying from 0 to pi. R is varying from 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 to 3 into 10 to the power minus 2, it is, I think, minus 2. And it is varying from 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. And what I will write here, R square sine theta. One second. No, we don't need to write here r square. So what is r? R is given as 3. 3 r is, in the question only, it is given as 3 r into 10 to the power minus 4. These things are given in the question only. This. So I'll write here 3 r into 10 to the power minus 4. So if you'll write this, now you need to integrate it. So for integration, what you will do here? So since it is an independent coordinate, all the terms are in multiplication, we will simultaneously integrate this. So what I will write here, so I will keep 3 into 10 to the power minus 4 outside and I will integrate r cube. What I will get here, r to the power 4 by 4 upon 3 into 10 to the power minus 2 into 2 into 10 to the power minus 2, my sine theta will become minus cos theta, and the limit for this will be from 0 to pi, 0 to pi, and third term will be phi, and that limit will be from 0 to 2 pi. So I think it will be not clear to, I'll write one more time. I'll solve it in a clear space. This will be not clear to you. So I'll write here, first formula will be, our formula will be rho v into dv, then the theta will become rho v. For a spherical shape, I told you to write here r square sine theta dr and d theta d phi. So for a sphere, it will become, now you just needed to substitute the formula here. So if you substitute the formula for this, it will be 0 to 2 pi. For phi, for theta, it will be 0 to pi. And this will be 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 into 3 into 10 to the power minus 2. And I will write here 3r into 10 to the power minus 4 into all these terms. So if I will integrate this, what I will get here? 3 into 10 to the power minus 4, r 4 upon 4, 3 into 10 to the power minus 2, 2 into 10 to the power minus 2. Sin theta will become minus cos theta. The limit will be 0 to pi. And for phi, I will write here 0 to 2 phi. If we'll open this, we'll get here 3 into 10 to the power minus 4, into 1 by 4 81 to 10 to the power 8 minus 16. So since it is a gate problem, it will be a bit complicated. It will not simple like RTU. So if you'll solve into your calculator, you'll get here this value. So if you are having any kind of doubt, so however you written any value, so please tell me. And this question of 8 mark in the subjective sections, so no negative marking was there. So you need to write this thing in the virtual calculator there. So after that, you will get the full marks in gate. So you have to write all those values, 6, 6, 1, 2, 0.3. So like this, you have to write there into 10 to the power minus 12. So then they will give you full marks. So that is because the gate is bit tough. You need to do practice there. If you are good in the practice, you can easily solve the problem of gate. So please tell me in this step, if you are finding any difficulties, please tell me. So you can, and others if are having any difficulties, Pratibha is, Aditi, Pratibha and others, other is clear with this question. No doubt. Okay, we'll solve another question. We'll go for another question which has come, and that question will be homework for you. So please try this. So question was like this: find the total charge contained in a cylindrical volume defined by rho is less than or equal to 2, and the coordinates will be 0 to z to 3, and rho v is given as 20 rho z. So this was the question. This was a homework question. I'll give you a hint in this, and so you just needed to do the integration for this. So I will definitely discuss the coordinates of all this volume, cylindrical sphere. So what you will do, you just needed to draw the figure first. So suppose this is our z, this is our y, and this is our x. So one cylinder is there. This is the cylinder. So just remember these two things, that r, theta and phi are those three terms which I've told in the sphere. So in the same thing, three terms are there. So this will be the phi terms. This will be the phi term. So three terms will be always there, though it is varying from three. So this coordinates will be three. And this will be our theta term. So, and this is given as two, if you'll see in the question. So this is 2, and this is varying from 0 to 3. So this z coordinate will be 3, I have written here, because this is z coordinates and this is y. So just remember one thing. So what you will do here, you will just apply the formula, since it is asking for whole cylinder. So three things will be there in that: rho v into rho into d phi, d rho and dz. These three things are there. To substitute those values, I will tell you how those three things have come in the next sessions. Now you just need to substitute those values and solve the integration. So this rho, I think it is given in the question, that is 20 rho z into 10 to the power minus 3. And this d phi dz, you will just need to write, and you will put the limit here. Three limits will be there. One limit will be from 0 to 3, second will be from 0 to 2 pi, third will be from 0 to 2. So what you need to do, you just needed to solve it by yourself and see if how much you can do. I have given you a hint. खुद से सोचना है कि सवाल कैसे हो रहा है, कैसे लिखा है सर ने। मैं अगले क्लास में आपको जब कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम पढ़ाऊंगा, स्फीयर का कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, फिर सिलेंडर का कोऑर्डिनेट सिस्टम, फिर एक कार्टेशियन को कोऑर्डिनेट्स में कैसे चेंज करते हैं, स्फेरिकल में कैसे चेंज करते हैं, तो ये सब वहीं पे आपको दिखेगा कि ये टर्म्स कहाँ से आया है। तो अभी के लिए फॉर टाइम बीइंग आई हैव टोल्ड यू दैट दिस टर्म्स यू नीड टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यूज हियर एंड सो टेल मी, सो ट्राई टू रीड इट राइट। इफ यू विल रीड अबाउट सिलेंडर यू विल गेट दिस टर्म्स ऑलरेडी, ऑल्दो आई विल डिस्कस इट। सो व्हाट यू हैव टू डू, यू हैव टू सब्स्टिट्यूट द वैल्यू देयर एंड यू हैव टू टेल मी द आंसर, और फॉर श्योर वी विल डिस्कस दिस क्वेश्चन इन द नेक्स्ट सेशन, नेक्स्ट क्लास व्हेन यू आर। सो व्हाट आई वांटेड दैट यू शुड पुट एन एफर्ट देयर सो दैट यू विल गेट एन आइडिया, सो इफ यू विल गेट एन आइडिया सो इट विल बी इजियर फॉर मी टू इम्प्लीमेंट इट हियर। सो इफ यू विल सी इन द बुक और इन द एनी अदर इन द इंटरनेट यू विल फाइंड एन आइडिया, सो गो गेट एन आइडिया एंड ट्राई टू सॉल्व दिस प्रॉब्लम, एंड इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी दैट यू विल सॉल्व इट ओनली, इफ नॉट आई विल सॉल्व इट इन द क्लास। सो दिस इज अ होमवर्क प्रॉब्लम। सो नाउ लाइन चार्ज, वॉल्यूम चार्ज, सर्फेस चार्ज इज ओवर, आफ्टर विल डिस्कस दिस प्रॉब्लम इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास, एंड वन मोर प्रॉब्लम विल बी देयर, विल सी फॉर ए सर्टन कोऑर्डिनेट्स, फॉर ए डीएल कोऑर्डिनेट्स, इफ दे आर आस्किंग फॉर दिस पॉइंट, सो लाइक दिस टाइप ऑफ प्रॉब्लम विल डिस्कस one more problem there in the next session. So it will be, now I think most of the things will be clear to you, some things are remaining that how I have written this and this, so I will discuss all the coordinate system of this in the next session, so please try to do this at home. So now I will show you some, we have for many days we have not seen biomedical, I think, so I will show you the syllabus and how much we have finished. So after that we'll see some biomedicals things also. My screen is visible to you. So in the biomedical we have discussed human xylology, I think human xylology we have finished. I had shared the PPT also of human xylology in the Google Classroom. So had we discussed human xylology? Is it finished? So please take part in the discussion now which we are discussing. So please answer me. So based on that we'll schedule our next class. Okay, so we are left with biomedical transducers. This all things we have left with. I think we have not discussed this biomedical transducer. So see, this is your syllabus of biomedical. If you'll study in 5 days, it will be over. So one thing, if you'll take in 1 day, so it will be over. So that's why I'm delaying this and I'm making more focus on that EMFT, because that syllabus is large. So this I will definitely finish it, but now I needed to take one class of biomedical. So most probably tomorrow or day after tomorrow we'll put one class for biomedical. So which topic you wanted to study, we'll choose from your side and we'll discuss that side. We'll discuss these topics. So syllabus is open to you. We have already finished with human xylology and biomedical transducers. I have given an outlook of biomedical transducer. I think I've told you something about biomedical transducer if I'm not wrong. So tell me the topic which we need to discuss in the next session, so we will deal with that. So should we move with the order which is given in this? Please take part in the discussion and give an answer. Don't be a mute. Don't be a silent killer. Participate kariye aur bataiye, jawab dijiye. Last unit, sir. Last unit, measurement of blood temperature, blood pressure flow. Okay, so one thing we'll do here, we will see about ultrasonic X-ray पेसमेकर, हार्ट लंग मशीन, दिस ऑल थिंग्स वी विल डिस्कस इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास. अल्ट्रासोनिक एक्सरे क्या होता है, अल्ट्रासोनिक क्या होता है, पेसमेकर, हार्ट लंग मशीन, ये सब चीज़ों को डिस्कस करेंगे. अगर आपको कोई दिक्कत नहीं हो, इफ यू आर हैविंग एनी डाउट एंड एनी डिफिकल्टीज, सो कैन वी टेक दिस टॉपिक फॉर द नेक्स्ट सेशन. ओके, सो वी विल डिस्कस दिस लास्ट यूनिट एंड वी विल ट्राई टू कवर दिस लास्ट यूनिट इन टू क्लासेस. सो प्रांजलि सिंह, आप बहुत यू आर एब्सेंट फॉर मैक्सिमम डेज एंड आई थिंक योर नेम इज गिवन टू द कॉलेज. सो बी अटेंडिव इन द क्लास, अदरवाइज यू आर गोइंग टू टे वी आर सर्चिंग फॉर योर पेरेंट्स फोन नंबर. एज सुन एज वील गेट वील इन्फॉर्म टू योर पेरेंट्स ऑल्सो. सो ट्राई टू बी अटेंडिव इन द क्लास, ट्राई टू अटेंड द क्लास. So we'll discuss this ultrasonic X-ray and all these things. We'll start with all these things. We'll discuss this on the Thursday or tomorrow, whenever it will be there. Whenever the class will be there, we'll discuss first biomedical because it's been long. I think we have not discussed this all these things. So we'll do this. And for the time being, please read what is ECG. Try to read ECG. ECG. These terms. ECG, EMG, and EEG. Try to read about this when you are free, when you have no work to do. So why I have told you to read this, because when you will get an overview, then I will show you here some videos how these things are working, how this ECG, EMG, EEG things are working, and why it is important in biomedical. So we'll discuss this last part, but for the time being, please try to read ECG, EMG, and EEG. Try to read by yourself. If you'll read by yourself, you'll get an idea for that. So please read it. And if any doubt, connect with me. So we'll meet in the next class. This class will be, I will post these videos in the YouTube college YouTube also. From there you can take the link, and if you are having any doubt, which the question which we have discussed, you can see there. So it's for today, it is enough. We'll meet in the next session.